Bonjour monsieur et madame, it is me le chef Reddit, today I have a special ala Reddit for you. Bon appétit and remember to subscribe.
People who read the terms and conditions of any website or game. What's something you think other people should know about them? In Apple T&C they say you can't use your Apple device to aid in building nuclear devices. Edit, holy fuck, these upvotes in my inbox is now officially fucked. Alcohol 120 gives you a week trial or so to test their software. In the terms it's said that if they realize you are pirating, cracked, patched, their software, they'll be installing malware into your system. 10/12 of a year ago, there was a warning in the iTunes EULA that said you shouldn't install the software on computers that operate nuclear reactors. Edit, I like how my highest upvoted comment ever, by a country mile, was a poorly worded comment about a EULA I read in college. Many applications on iOS or Android will charge a one-time fee to purchase said app. After you pay that fee you now have the app. Right? Well, for a while. Maybe even forever, but don't count on it. Many, not all, but a large number will let you know that this app could well be sold to another company and as such, that new company may make changes to the app and decide to charge you again to keep the app. Or they may do away with the app altogether, despite the fact that you spent your hard-earned money on it. They might even change it to a monthly subscription. The bottom line is, when you pay for an app, you are ostensibly paying to use that app for an undisclosed amount of time. A website pointed out that on Instagram's T&C one of them says you do not own the photos and they can use them in any promotions they use. And #X200B. I am not sure if this is still the case as it was a few years ago. In a timed game of chess, you are not allowed to attack the chess clock. Edit, the players must handle the chess clock properly. It is forbidden to punch it forcibly, to pick it up or to knock it over. Improper clock handling shall be penalized in accordance with Article 13.4, Article 6.7.c of the FIDE Laws of Chess 2014. They later changed the wording to press it forcibly, presumably because the thought of people punching the clock was too graphic for the sport. Pokemon Go, in Niantic's privacy policy, they clearly disclose that they have the right to basically sell your data, share, to third parties for industry and marketing purposes, with your permission, which I assume users give when agreeing to the TS, however it will be anonymized. They can give it non-anonymously when issued a subpoena or warrant however. I'd have to assume this data is very very valuable because it is tied geographically, and can speak volumes about user behavior. The old first-person shooter America's Army. You could not distribute the game in Iraq, Iran, and a whole bunch of other countries. You own nothing, and whatever you have in-game can be seized with no warning or recompense. You basically rent Steam games. You don't own a thing in your library. This is so that they can revoke your play if you use cheats, I think. That you can't do anything to stop them if they chose to share your data. Bethesda is entitled to setting a hitman on you just to scare you if you use mods. Any contest you enter with AI gives them exclusive rights to take your ideas without reimbursement to profit from. Some of you may have agreed to become a member of the first human centipede. The advertisements, sales documentation, and website will go on and on about how great the product is, what it can do for you, how secure it is, and how they respect your privacy. The fine print says, 1. We make no claims about whether our product is fit for use. It may be complete garbage regardless of what our salespeople told you. 2. The internet is dangerous. Shit happens. We make no claims about the security or safety of our product. 3. We will give your data to every subcontractor, partner, and marketing agency we use now or in the future. We have no idea what they do with it or how they protect it and will not be responsible for their actions. 4. Any promise or claim we make can be instantly invalidated by our posting something different at a later date on our website, e.g. privacy policy, terms and conditions for use. If you read closely, some of them insert very funny little clauses that have nothing at all to do with their products. EA actually owns your soul. In Counter-Strike you agree to face legal action if you use any of the game's audio in constructing explosives. I actually want to know if there's a single soul who read terms and conditions in its entirety. It's pretty standard stuff. The only thing that might surprise you is that it says you pretty much don't actually own the software, and that you agree to deal with any legal issues through arbitration instead of courts. Many T&C for games will make it abundantly clear that you don't actually own the game. What you own is a license to access the game. This is why they can add, remove, or change anything they want and you won't be entitled to a refund. Nuclear bomb rules is funny. It's specifically illegal to use a nuclear bomb in Germany. The rule is great because it's only illegal if people or things are potentially threatened. The penalty is 1 to 10 years in prison. Unless it kills someone, then it's 5 years to life. Unless it's done negligently, then it's up to 3 years.
Thank you for watching. What was your favorite answer? Do you have a better one? Comment it down below. Au revoir.